Thanks, Jeff.
Even harder to get people together to work and
make sure that all of our time line up. So what we're trying to do is take all of the work out of it. So this is how it works. It uses a list just like a checklist, except the list is any activity that you might be interested in, anything from bowling, fishing. It uses a search algorithm much like video games use, and that you might see video game players use. And then it allows you to customize and search for what you're trying to do. So if you're looking for, say, to go bowling, and you're willing to travel within this distance, what we do is we look for other people, maybe willing to travel this, here, 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 and here. And instead of you having to find where to go, we search within that criteria on that star there and try to see if there's a location that's suitable for everyone and a time. And with, after you verify who you are for safety reasons, we automatically populate your group. And places where people can go are everywhere from approved businesses to gyms, rec centers. And there's only one competitor, and that's Meetup.com, which some of you are very familiar with. The only issue with Meetup is it charges people to start the activity. So it's $15 a month for someone to try to bring people together, and I don't think that's okay. So what we try to do is we make this free for anyone to use. Any user is free. The only people that we charge are the people who would make money off of our users. These are all the reasons that ours is superior to Meetup.com in every single way. We automatically form groups. We take the guesswork out of where you're gonna go, what time you're gonna go, the social anxiety of asking yourself where you wanna go. It's free, and we don't discriminate based upon anything that you can see here. So everyone is included. So the big question is, how is this going to make money? Because that's what we're all here for. Well, it makes money because, how does it make money? Because it is an advertisement. We are sending customers into stores. And I think people would pay pretty decent money for that. We have geographic locations of where markets are that we can show investors, and they would pay good money to know where to put a business. And we can also advertise baseball gloves to baseball players, golf gloves to golfers, so on and so forth. So with your help, we might be able to finally put social back in social networking. Thank you.
Questions?
I'd be curious to know at what stage you are in your business process right now.
We just finished building the back-end database and store system where we're going to store user information. And we're currently developing the front end where we're still in the alpha phase.
So when will this go live?
I guess that's depending on the resources that we throw at it. We're hoping before Masters, but it might not be until next year. But we would like to release it right before summer. So kids getting out of school right before Masters, and there's a lot of fun things to do when it's warm outside. So that's hopefully when we will have this going live. But yes,
sir. When you scratch your I'm not familiar with them. Is it Meetup? I don't use Meetup, but so I'm not familiar with this experience. Do I just say, hey, I'm interested in mountain biking? And
yes.
And it's going to match me up with other people that I don't know already that are interested in mountain biking, and it's going to recommend a place to go to meet these people?
Yes. Well, what our job is to find suitable locations that are safe. My business partner, Christopher Dial, is actually a police officer, and he's the one that helps me with this. So our sole purpose is to find places that are well-monitored, well-maintained, reputable places to send people to get people out in the community. Kind of how like when Pokemon Go was released like a year ago, how everyone was out and then all of a sudden it just died. He said lots of crimes that normally wouldn't be solved were solved just because there were so many people doing so much. And so this, but Pokemon Go died out. This will grow exponentially because this will grow with the trends.
Do you see it expanding past the Augusta market, or is this, are we sort of like your testing city?
This is my testing city because the first people I'd like to market this to are veterans and college students. I myself am a veteran, and one of the biggest challenges we have when active duty is finding things to do whenever we go to a new location. And students and military are that they always get displaced and go to new places where they don't know anyone. And this is a simple way for you to meet other people who have common interests, much the same as you guys.
So what can we do to help you? I mean, I've got ideas and people that I feel like I can connect you to, but what are you specifically looking for?
Well, in order for this to work, I have to have permission from, I guess, businesses to expand public places to send people to. So first I need, I guess I just need community help, and I need community involvement, and I need to get the word out to let people know, because the one thing I don't want to happen is someone say, find me someone, and there not being anyone else on the other side, if that makes sense.
Do you already have connections to some locations, or?
Not currently. Right now we're more focused on the development of how the application is actually gonna work, to make it as safe as possible while still keeping it anonymous to protect user identity and to make sure that that everyone who uses this will be safe. But once that's taken care of, then we'll worry more about the getting approved to the location.
So is it all like activities, or like say I wanted to go to a place like one cafe, but I don't want to go sit by myself?
Yes.
You never answered my question.
Really close to
someone.
You know what my point was?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, absolutely. That's not only things like going to the movie not by yourself, but and eating by yourself, even volunteer work. There's people say they're bored all the time, especially online. But I don't think they're bored. I think they just don't have people to do the things they want to do with. And so one of the reasons I'm designing it this way, especially the anonymity, is because, take for example, a pretty girl. If a pretty girl has a profile picture on there, more than likely a guy around her age is gonna try to get into a group with her. But if no one knows that she's a pretty girl, they're not gonna be able to have a bias whether or not they want to join her or someone else that they wouldn't normally join. So it's going to allow connections that normally wouldn't connect.
Great idea. My question is, why do you need to contact the business? Is it that you get a discount or something? Is there an open place?
Yes. Well, that's one of the reasons. And I also just want to make sure that I haven't really gotten completely through the legal aspect of it, but if somebody was to get hurt doing an activity at the business and they could come back and blame me, I'm just trying to cover all my bases. But really, I guess that's, like I said, I'm still in alpha phase, so I'm even taking suggestions, but there are many things about the way that I have this blueprinted out that are, it's to protect everyone.
Well, that, and for them to pay for advertising.
Yes,
so that's why you're going to support, right?
So the way I wanted to do this is I wanted to make any location that's suitable completely free. And the way it's going to work is kind of how like Hulu, you can watch movies, but if you want commercial free, you have to pay for it. With businesses, we'll weight it. So if one business pays, say, a monthly fee, we will send a few more customers into their door than we would the other people. And this is something that we can actually track. So if it's something cheap that's only like, you know, $2, then we can only charge them, you know, 10 cents for every customer. But if it's something expensive like skydiving that costs $200, well, we can charge them $10-$20 a person. And they benefit and we benefit because we're literally sending them customers through the door. Yes, sir.
And I was just saying another reason you may want to contact a business owner is because if 50 people want to do a particular activity at a particular time, they all converge on a 20 person business.
Yes, sir.
Seating. There could be an issue. But it seems like for sort of a beta, you could choose a couple of different things like paintballers. Since a lot of those businesses are gone away, you got these guys that love to get out there and get active. It seems like you could use that as a beta to get some feedback and figure out what works and what doesn't work and that sort of thing. And mountain bikers, that would be awesome, that sort of thing.
Yes, sir.
How do you get people who once have used the app to find each other to come back? Because once I meet the six of you, or however many, to go bowling, why would I come back on and use it again? Because I now know this is like, why don't we make a Facebook group? How do you get people to continue to come back?
Well, I guess it's more marketing towards the people who don't have the groups, the people who don't have somewhere to go, the people who have trouble getting out, because oftentimes my schedule doesn't match up with my friends, but I'll have free time, and I don't want to actively go out and find. What this does is this just says, I'm free right now. Is there anybody else that wants to do something with me? And if there happens to be anyone free, as long as they're somewhat polite, respectful, and they're not out to hurt me, then I have no problem doing what I love and sharing with others.
Grace, who was the fellow that was here a couple months ago and he spoke, and he had like the traveling video game, the virtual video game.
Steven.
Yeah. It sounds like a really good connection because you can do a little test with it, right?
Sure. Like
smiling crazy because virtual reality is a thing. They need to find each other so then they can go into another dimension, right?
Yes. Virtual reality meetups.
All right, last question. Do you have kind of workings in mind for like one of type events, festivals, or things that might not be a recurring activity that people can do, but a way to bring groups together at a festival that comes through town or something that only lasts for a limited amount of time?
That will take a little bit more hardware than I think initially we're going to do small, and if we grow, we can grow into that. From the feedback that I'm getting from people and all the research I've done, that it doesn't seem like this idea would be very hard to grow. So that is definitely the foreseeable future. And one of the hard things is trying to make sure that to keep the groups small enough so there's interaction, so it's not just one person in a big crowd of people, but it's a small enough group of people that they're kind of forced to interact, if that makes sense.